Hello everyone, this is Sensei Starman and welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 3. Well, last time you recall, we entered into the Shadowfell. Balthazar came after us and we just defeated him and looted the bodies of him and all his undead minions after a somewhat harrowing but mostly one-sided fight, which somehow leveled us all up to level 8. And I thought I'd show you all the leveling up process for those who are curious about these sorts of things. So, Matthias! Gaining another level of Bard. Now we get to choose another spell. Given how important being able to teleport around has become, I'm going to go ahead and take Dimension Door. But I now have the option to replace a spell. So I could get rid of Polymorph, Fear, Speak with Dead, Detect Thoughts, Hold Person. Yeah. Fear has not been nearly as useful as I'd hoped, so we will go ahead and forget it in favor of greater invisibility, which I haven't been using that too much, but it kind of fits my sneaky motif. Now let's actually take a look at some of the feats. Your proficiency is doubled for deception and perform, would be appropriate. Gain a plus 5 to initiative and can't be surprised. Strength and dexterity increases to a maximum of 20. I haven't actually had much call for perform of late. Lucky, 3 luck points. Well, I could use those, but spell smiter, you learn a cantrip, and the number you roll a critical hit is reduced by 1 with spells. Tavern Brawl, we make an unarmed attack using prized weapon. The strength modifier is added to twice the damage. Warcaster. Yeah, I was hoping for something like Deceptive, which would just give me an overall bonus toward trickery, but you know what? Actor is appropriate. Very much mistaken. Oh, there's where the dialogue thing is. I was trying to bring up the full character sheet list. Okay, did not mean to take the quick rest, but well, we still got 2 short rests, and I get the feeling we're going to need to go into it. Spellcook, alchemy. Yeah, charisma is now a 20 plus 10. My deception is plus 16, performance is plus 15, persuasion is plus 16. Not bad, okay.
Don't burn yourself.
Let's go ahead and level Karlik. Does not get much apart from possibility of changing Bestial Heart. We do also get a feat for her. Or an ability improvement. Also give her magic ability, Medium Armor Master. Doesn't impose disadvantage on stealth checks. The most your armor class you gain from your dex most increases to plus 3 instead of plus 2. Her dex is not quite that good, though, but Savage Attacker. When making melee weapon attack, you roll your damage dice twice and use the highest result. That sounds like a good one for Karlik. I think I'm gonna hold off on leveling Shadowheart. But Gale. Actually, not gonna hold off, but I will level her up. I get the feeling we're gonna wanna respec her. Alright, so we can prepare spells. Banishment strikes me as very helpful. We haven't really been using Inflict much, but... as for feet... could make her heavily armored, so she can start using the really good armor, but nah, I think we'll stick with ability improvement. Hit up her wisdom, and buff her dex up a bit.
Seek and you shall find.
And Gale. Well, he gets another two spells, but here's the funny part. It looks like we've got almost every level 4 spell there is. And as for prepared spells, I think we'll go ahead and set up a dimension door. Haven't had much use for whole person, so we'll go ahead and prepare. Ooh, Phantasmal Killer is a fun one. Ice Storm can be useful. But there's one I want to be sure we have prepared that I have not been preparing, which would be ludicrously useful. Yeah, had I been thinking about it, I could have used this to open the vault in the Gauntlet of Shar earlier, but no matter. Witchbolt, Thunderwave, Fireball, Haste. Haste and Slow, haven't been using those much either. I think that'll be a good one. And as for a feat, well... actually, let's boost Intelligence and Dex. Alright, so with that done... let's get the group back together.
Can't afford to stay idle.
And let Shadowheart determine her destiny.
Balthazar has drawn his final rancid breath. Pity it was not my hand that brought it about. Instead, it was you. You, who have come to seek the praise of your wicked goddess. You, who have come to drive a dagger through my heart.
Not a dagger, a spear. My Lady Shah's spear. Her fate is mine to seal. Let me handle this.
The fate you seal is your own. To be a Dark Justicia is to turn your heart from everything but loss. You will know no love, no joy, only servitude. Until, of course, your mistress inevitably discards you. And there is much she does not tell you. A terrible blood price that may extend beyond my own death.
You feel Shadowheart bristling. This is important to him. But your bond is strong. You may yet be able to sway her from the path of duty to the path of light. And Nightsong is not blind to your conflict. Behind that raging heart is the restless beat of one who knows too well that her fate hangs in the balance.
Yeah, so I'm thinking gentle touch is the way to handle this, because the grand irony is that for somebody who has been manipulated by her goddess every step of the way of this quest, Shadowheart really does not like being manipulated or having seen other people be manipulated. Unless you're the one doing the manipulating for a nominally good cause. So I'm going to trust her and not step in. I'm going to try and talk to her.
Well, well, well. What's that I sense? A spear intended for my heart? Empowered by your goddess, I. Empowered to kill the child of a god. Do you know what I am, little assassin? For I know you. A lost child, frightened by wolves in the dark.
What did you say?
Much has been promised to you, hasn't it? But what has been taken from you? What do you know of your own heart? Your own life? I sense more in you than you know.
Whatever you think you know of me won't matter once I become who I'm meant to be.
Okay. This might be the time to do it, but she knows something. I can spare her and see what she has to say.
I just did that. Lady Shah will disown me. What will happen to me?
Not what will happen. What will you do? Your past is not yet lost. Your future is not yet fixed. Lay a hand on me in friendship, not quite Sharon. And I will fight the battle that has been waiting for me this last century. Then, oh then, we will have much to discuss. Given me a great gift, little warrior. Don't you find it also curious that you would spurn your dark lady? Perhaps you feel a stirring of the truth already. But that will come later. There is a battle yet to be fought. You have done what we feared was impossible. You have released me from a century of sorrow. Your power is great. So too must be your weapon. You must choose what you will wield. And the Moon Maiden will provide. Thus I have said, Thus will it be so. Are you ready?
Ready for what? Darkly be merciful. What have I done? To have this place? Absolutely.
To kill Ketherick Thorne.
Yeah, I'd say I'm ready for that. I'm sure she is.
We need to leave. Lady Shar won't stand for us to be here, not after what we did.
If Shar is angry, she's being remarkably quiet about it.
That's what frightens me. She must be angry. Yet, I don't feel it. Or hear it. There's only silence.
There's nothing worse than an angry woman giving you the silent treatment.
Whatever's coming, I don't want to be in the heart of the Shadowfell when it finds me.
An angry goddess has got to be about...
be headed for Moonrise Towers. We'd better get there.
A billion times worse.
See what she's unleashed against Ketherick Thorne.
Okay, so we just got a portal, but... the reward is Shadowheart has just gotten a Moonlight Glaive. Which, two-handed weapon, lost the shield. But then again, Gloomstrand shield didn't really seem appropriate to her anymore anyway. Still have the other one. Alright, well, let's...
Well chosen, Shadowheart.
Ketherick has the wrath of the heavens upon him now, and no hope of resurrection.
Give it a try.
Please, my lady. Forgive me.
Something's amiss. Shadowheart, what happened? Why did you vanish like that?
I thought I was done for. Perhaps I might have been dead. This is all like some sort of terrible dream. But it's real, isn't it? I stood before the Night Song. I heard Lady Shar's words. And I failed her. Worse than failed her, I defied her. Just because of what that Asimar said. I tried to leave. But Shar blocked me. Punished me for failing her. I thought I knew the limit of pain that the incurable wound could inflict, but... I had no idea. It felt like I was suffering the agony of a thousand people all at once. My blood was boiling, my hair was on fire. I thought I'd claw my own face off with the pain. But then she released me. Banished me, more like. She said I was an outcast. That all of her children would know me and revile me.
Shadowheart looks distraught, abandoned by her goddess and all former allies. And as for her divine magic, admitting who empowers her now may break her spirit for good.
alone in the end unless you count the tadpole. Oh, we know what I'm gonna say.
I suppose I do, don't I? You've done more to help me than my faith has in recent times, if I'm honest. Thank you. There's been something between us for some time. A connection. More than friends. I recognized it, but didn't act on it. I thought my faith was the most important thing in my life. I couldn't have been more wrong. I've squandered too much time already. I want to be with you. Now and always. Do you want the same?
I do. I've wanted this for a long time.
It wasn't too long ago that I could never imagine smiling again. Shows what I know.
Night Song promised she'd tell me something about myself. I need to speak with her as soon as I can.
What she said to me back in the Shadowfell about the wolves, that's no coincidence.
She took flight to hunt down Kethric Thorm. All I can do is help hasten his demise, and hope that answers soon follow.
I'm here for you if you need me. I thought you might need reminding after everything.
Thank you. I think any attempts at comforting me might be in vain just now. But you're sweet to keep me in your thoughts.
Yeah, we can discuss viewings later. We've got bad guy to smite. And when the chance arises, I'm going to speak to Night Song again. Whatever she claims to know, it may just help me make sense of everything. And it looks like Gale has something to say, too.
Your cheeks are flush. There's a twinkle in your eye. I think I am no longer the cause.
You were never the cause, my
Since
dude.
You found your heart's desire. But with someone else. And who would I be to stand in the way of such a union? I assume you didn't come here to seek my blessing, though. Was there something else you needed?
Nope, not as such. And how about you, Karlik? Anything to say about...
I hate seeing Shadowheart suffer like this. All for doing the right thing. It's up to us to look after her now. If she needs a rest, we carry her. If she needs a hand, she has ours. If she needs ears, we've got four between us. Whatever she needs.
Funny as it would be to say, yeah, I need you to stay behind in camp now. So anyway. We're at the mausoleum. The barrier is still up. That's a good sign. But the land is still shadowy and dark, even though it looked like the Night Song was chasing the shadows away. Well, nothing else for it but to go join the battle, I think. But we will go ahead and save game here. And I'm going to go ahead and stop video, even though we've still got a few minutes, because I get the feeling this next one is going to be big, and we're going to need the full half hour for the fight to come. But thank you all for watching. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. Leave a comment if you are so inclined. And we'll continue the adventure next time. Take care until then.